Shalom, brothers. Barakatah Yehovah, Barakatah Yehovah Shai. Barakatah Yehovah by Hashem Yehovah Shai. Shalom, this is Apostle Rakar. Back once again, I'm on my way out the door, actually, but the Spirit was on me, man. I just wanted to throw this quick little impromptu video up there, man. And you can say this is just a quick little response to a video that I just saw that the other elders in my camp text, you know, they put it up on our group chat that we have with each other. And basically, man, it was a video that the Levite brother, I believe his name is Daniel Allah, and GMS down in Miami, down there in Florida. I believe the Miami camp. And, you know, I'm not going to go into big details. I mean, the video's up. The brother puts, there's no secret. You know, something happened to the brother. I believe his name is Daniel Allah. And by the way, brother, if you see this video, the brother's right now had a little incident. Something happened to the brother, and he ended up in the hospital, you know. And by the way, brother, Daniel Allah, I believe that's your name. I hope I got it correct, man. If it's not, I apologize. Salakia, but I want to say, hey, brother, hey, Yahawabashim, Yahawashai, Barakatah, man. Barak, Rapah, Kazak Lab, you know, Bahashem Yahawashai to that brother, you know, because he went through something happened to him, I guess, this last week, and the brother he's up in the hospital, but he's healing, and the Lord is with the brother, man. But brother, I just want to say, I saw the video that he did. It was a heavy video, and it was a testimonial he was given, because the situation, what happened to him, but the Lord was with him. The Lord kind of brought some judgment down on the brother, but then the Lord was with him, and it's heavy. And by watching the video, yes, it put me in fear, because if the Most High do things like that, he could do it. Hey, man, the Most High jack people up in the world. He jack up Esau and these nations, but he'll chastise the men of the Lord too. And the brother brought out the scripture where it says, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, man. Okay. And then the scriptures also say, what? Whom the Lord love, he chasteneth. And you know what? That's true, man. So if you're a servant of the Most High, you're going to get chastened. Things going to happen to you. It ain't going to be an easy ride into the kingdom. Like some of these other guys be talking about, some of these other groups be talking about, oh, yeah, man. Like these General Yohanna and his crew. Now they walking around with them fancy garments with swords and all that. Yeah, brother, this is it, man. Yeah, this is it. We taking over. Nah, man, it ain't going to be an easy ride into the kingdom. What do the scripture says? Through much tribulation shalt thou enter into the kingdom of heaven. Through much tribulation. Meaning we're going to be catching hell right up until Yahweh Shai come. Okay, that's why Yahweh Shai said what? They that be whole have no need of a physician, but they that are sick. So that meant the physician is Yahweh Shai when he come back. He gonna deliver us out of here. Lord willing, we be of the hopeful elect, man. All right? That's why we waiting for him to come back in his glory. Because we're gonna be sick. Meaning physically, emotionally, mentally, we all checked up. Okay? We ain't gonna be healthy. We ain't gonna be Superman when Yahweh Shai get back. But when Yahweh Shai come back, he gonna turn the ones of us that are of the elect, he gonna turn us into Superman. That's why I said, did that be whole? Because we're not whole. We all messed up. We all jacked up, man. But that also is cause for us to be humble, man. That humbles us. It makes you be humble and realize that the Most High, man, could jack us up. The Lord could just decide to jack us up for something we did 10 years ago or jack us up for something we did in a past life. But then still, at the same time, have mercy on you. We quoted the scripture, okay, like a father chastises his son. And the brother, the Levite brother, he brought out those scriptures, man. And that was a beautiful testimonial that he gave. And yes, man, what the brother went through, it put fear in you, man. It invokes fear in you, and it should. Okay, because like Apostle Gabar always says, or always quotes, or says, the Most High is someone to be feared, man. The scripture says, who can deliver out of his hand? And nothing and nobody can save you. If the Lord got your number, man, that's it. He gonna punch your ticket right there. Or he'll just jack your ass up to make you wish that you was dead. You see, that's why it's always something that I've always said, man, pray to the Lord for forgiveness. Hey, send up that scripture, Psalms 51, okay? That's a prayer to always keep, take not thy Holy Spirit from me, okay? He could do that. And the Lord have judged guys. Yo, man, that's even worse. The Most High have judged certain guys, and they don't even know that the Most High judged them. Okay, I'll give you an example. The Most High could do something to you physically, but really, what's worse is mental, man. To be walking around out here bugged out of your mind, and you don't even know that you bugged out of your mind, man. Like all these different guys that was in this truth at one time, but now they back in the world walking around bugged out. Certain guys, they were in the truth, and they left the truth, and they became Afrocentric. Like that one dude that's down with Sarnetta and them, Sankuku, we call him. Here it is, that nigga was in the truth. He used to go out to the camp, he used to teach. He used to call upon the name of Yahweh and Yahawashah. Then the Most High just zapped him. And then one day, he woke up, and all of a sudden, now that's not the truth. We Africans, I'm an African. I'm Kemet, I'm Kemetic. And he's just woke up one day and the Most High zapped him. And then now he's walking around bugged out with them Afrocentric niggas coming against the truth. That's a chastisement for your ass. That's why in Psalms 51, what it say? Take not thou thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy gladness, right? You see what I'm saying? You're supposed to pray to the Lord for forgiveness every day. Pray for forgiveness for our sins, man. Because the Lord could just jack us up. But to jack you up and leave you alive, you better off if the Lord, like, put a judgment on you. You might get burnt up or hit by a car or shot or whatever might happen. But then the Lord save your life and still have mercy on you. Okay? You understand what I'm saying? That's truly a man of the Lord, but the Lord still have mercy on you. You understand what I'm saying? Killing you is one thing, man. That's the easy way out. But the Lord, man, so it's like, that's why we got to constantly be humble in this truth and constantly pray to the Lord for our sins and then pray for the brotherhood. We got to constantly pray for one another, man. Okay? Constantly pray for the brotherhood. But it's true, man. The scripture say what? Through much tribulation shalt thou enter the kingdom of heaven. So we're going to have different things. We're going to have infirmities. We're going to be sick. We ain't going to be in tip-top health. I mean, brothers, you know, we believe in taking the herbs and exercising. You know, we do the best we can. The scripture said, the apostle Paul said, what? Bodily exercise profiteth little. Because you could be Jack LaLanne, man. You know, you could be in the Mr. Olympia contest with Arnold Schwarzenegger and all these guys, but then the Lord could take you. But there's nothing wrong with that because the Apostle Paul said it do profiteth. Okay, so you know, brothers should exercise, work out, train, you know, try to eat as healthy as we possibly can, and make sure you get the water up in you, and you know, the deal with the herbs and stuff like that. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. Yeah, I do it myself. Other brothers do it. You understand what I'm saying? It's needful because it subsides all these infirmities and shit that's going on and all the poisons that Esau got out here trying to take us out with, man. But over all this faith, the scripture says what? The just shall live by faith, man. All right? But yeah, man, but it's like the video that the brother did from Florida, the Levite brother, a brother, that was a very edifying and moving video, man. And brother, we all praying for you and we pray. You know, we love you, man. We love all the brothers. And hey, brother, like, the scriptures say all we got is the men of the Lord. That's why Yahawashah said he washed the disciples' feet on the night of the Passover before he was crucified. So he said, look, what I do for you, should you not do for one another? So that was Yahawashah telling us. We got to look out for each other. We got to humble ourselves to each other. Hey, amen. If we ever offended any brothers or anything, you pray to the Lord for forgiveness and seek forgiveness of the brothers. And continue on in faith, man. But just know it's not going to be an easy ride. Like the scripture say, hey, if the Lord don't chastise you, then you're not a son, then you're a bastard. So you know what? You shouldn't look for things to go easy all the time, man. If things are going too easy, man, for myself personally, there be points, man, where things be going too smooth. I get scared, man. I be like, I don't know, man. Maybe I might not be a man of the Lord because yo, I haven't caught no hell in a couple of months. Shit is going too smooth. You get nervous. You get nervous, man. Because you don't want to be a bastard. You want to be a son. Man, we all get chastised, man. We've been being chastised for years. Hey, and it's not just maybe something happening to you. It could be on the scoffers. That was chastisement, man. They have to bear all that shit. You know, low-life motherfuckers doing videos on you and putting your personal business out there and got other people laughing at you and mocking you and, you know what I'm saying, scoffing you, harassing you and shit. That's chastisement to have to bear that, man. People bearing false witness on you, lying on you, okay? All that shit. Being homeless, not knowing where you're going to sleep or not knowing what you're going to do. Okay, I mean, whatever, man. Anything that makes your life uneasy, you know, your car breaking down, you know what I'm saying? Whatever, man, that's chastisement, man, on all different levels. These demonic evil forces messing with you, messing with your head, being sick, you know, you coming down with high blood pressure, diabetes, that shit is grievous, man. It's painful. That's all so you know what, man, embrace it. Whatever hell and infirmities or whatever we're going through, brothers, embrace that, man. Because that's the chastisement of the Lord. That's the Lord purging us, man, like in Zechariah. It says, and I will bring the third part through the fire. That's the fire too, man. All the hell that we're catching. That's the chast the Lord purging us. Because the brother quoted the scripture. That's beautiful. We'd rather be judged not than judged with the world, man. So we'd rather, let us catch hell. We don't care. Let us go through it. Because when the Most High judged the world, which ultimately is those nuclear missiles, the majority of these people in the world, like the brother, I'm going to steal your phrase, brother, but it's true. The majority of these people going to eat nuclear missiles, man. They worried about some coronavirus. They going to eat nuclear missiles, man. And America's going to totally be destroyed. If you hear when the missiles drop, if you ain't getting beamed up in them ships, so you better pray. We better pray that we be of the elect. Because if you're not on that, if you ain't got a ticket on them chariots, when them missiles hit this place, you're going to be burnt to a nuclear crisp, man. It's going to be so bad, ain't going to be nothing but ashes left here. So when it's all said and done, this is going to, from New York City to California, ain't going to be nothing left standing. Just one big desert, man. And like the scriptures say, no man shall ever inhabit this place again. The only thing that's going to end up popping up is some scorpions and maybe some snakes. The scripture said that. America's going to vanish. It's going to be as if this place was never here, man. Babylon the Great. And Barakatai Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. For water Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai for that. But yeah, brothers, man, that's just a video I wanted to put out real quick. Amen to that brother. Hey, brother Barak Rapah. Wa'akazak Alab, man. Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. Babakul Shai. Hey, brother, may the Lord continue to heal you more. And the Lord is definitely with you, brother. And stay strong, man. That's the rest of you brothers, man. But remember, we got to be humble in this truth. And we got to be serious about this thing. All right? I'll be back, Lord willing, Abba Ratazai, man, if the Lord permits. Shalom, brothers.